Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Door here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to The Boys Season 3 Episode 5, titled The Last Time to Look on This World of Lies. Did you know chimpanzees are an endangered species, likely because of human activity? But you can help by supporting construction costs for Crimson Countess's Chimp Country. This beautiful refuge for chimpanzees will feature a banana plantation, 4 daily stunt shows, and a petting zoo. And when you donate, you'll be entered to win a private video chat with Crimson Countess. Donate today. Now, you may notice something interesting with that, in that I was able to finally read the full synopsis of an episode. Because by the looks of it, Amazon Prime has updated, Amazon has updated their description box to actually show the full thing, finally. Now, why this couldn't have happened before I started doing reactions to this, who knows, but I am happy to get the full thing now. Anyway, so, couple notes from the, well, really one note from the last episode is, I was, for basically the entire first scene with Maeve and Starlight, trying to remember what Adora says to turn into She-Ra, because Maeve's sword really looked like She-Ra's sword. It's for the honor of Grayskull. I could only think of By the Power, which is He-Man's one, but yeah, it was for the honor that I couldn't remember. And then when we got to the whole Kimiko dildo fight, I was saving a comment for the end of the video about how they had basically She-Ra's sword and Glimmer's voice actress in the same episode, because Karen, which is Kimiko's actress, voices Glimmer in the Netflix cartoon, and they had her using a Maeve-inspired dildo which looks like a sword. And since her sword looks like Adora's sword, it was technically Glimmer using Adora's sword, if you look at it through several lenses placed in front of each other so they obscure the image, but it's there. Anyway, let's get this started in 3, 2, 1, go. And play. Why does it sometimes work and sometimes not? Oh wait, no. The dildo didn't look like the sword. It looked like Maeve's armor, but it was shaped like a sword. Interestingly, he didn't mention Maeve's involvement, or we don't know of him mentioning it. No, Alex never knew that Maeve was a part of it, so it makes sense that A-Train wouldn't. But she was also there in the, when they were watching the press conference, so. Could he have assumed? And you're in there without any suit? He used the power to destroy the powers. Yeah, there's the green shit. You're handling a lot better this second time. I'm assuming that was his brother as a kid, but... You're not getting the nomination. I don't know what that is. What the fuck's he gotta do? Really, it's going to be his fucking wife controlling everything. They had to take the Y, didn't they? How the fuck does opioids completely eviscerate a person? We found something. Compared, considering how their relationship started. Clench your butt and jump. That actually sounds like a My Hero Academia reference. Until, of course, Maeve gives you the next dose. So, here's the thing. I don't actually know if Jensen is in, like, going to be in the next season. Because I don't know what happens with Soldier Boy. I only know that he was in it. He's somehow gotten into the back end of a airport. Seems like someone's coming to America. There we go. That's a big bag of them. Are these two gonna hook up? I don't think so, but Turned you into the you you didn't want to be. So it's basically like the Super Soldier Serum, but from the comics. Good man good, bad man worse. Eh, I fucking called it. I think you'd fucking crush his pelvis. I fucking called it. It's a weird combination. Frenchie, you're not gonna do it. It's probably the first time you felt pain like this in a long time. She's got no powers. It is a fair question. No, it's not. Really? That's all you're doing, A-Train? An apology? And what would happen if Homelander apologized to you? Would that make you feel better? No. It'd make you feel like shit. Make it feel like he doesn't care even more. Well, he was atomized. No, he's having a panic attack. Oh, right, I forgot you had. What was it? FBI? No, CIA. You said that last time, then you showed up on my doorstep. Why does he have to have a camera crew? How is he going to fuck this up royally in 5 minutes? This is going very bad. Fucking Oh, he's now is the fucking blue. And this is all on camera. Yeah, A trait. Now you see. Oh, fuck, that's his brother. Yeah. Gotta be honest, I like that guy. Don't know half the people he mentioned, but. So, this came out during A, the Black Lives Matter thing, and B, the COVID, and in the same episode, they had All Lives Matter, the equivalent of Blue Lives Matter, and someone telling them to ignore restrictions and go to very public places. Have you ever heard his name before? I was under the assumption he didn't have a civilian identity. No. They say the worst you can say is no. What's he got in the... Is MM going to? I don't think so. That's fair. No. I wonder what happens if you swallow it. Like, if it's ingested into your bloodstream, you get... You're not talking any sense into Ashley. The last time she was asked to be human, she did genuinely apologize. Write it down. If you can't say it, because you know he'll hear, write it down. Sure, he'll hear the pen scratching, but I doubt he can discern. Oh, good, at least he's not dead. You know, if you'd have stuck with... if you'd have stuck with, Starlight, then she might have actually helped you. She said something. She spoke. See, when I saw the thumbnail, I thought this was going to be a legit musical episode, which I unapologetically love in every show. I love musical episodes, especially in shows where it makes no sense, but... No, we get this dream sequence. Too bad they were on a different floor, otherwise we could have got an A-train in on this as well. So did she even actually speak? Now he's the one to run from the kiss. And I'm making it back to, yep. Poor Kimiko. Yeah, those are large. And this is. I thought you wanted to tape her hands apart. Maybe they are. You already knew that. You guys, but I'm not sure you guys, but she at least betrayed it. She's the one who said he was dead. So, Stormfront and Soldier Boy, they don't age, yet Crimson Countess does. And I think Gunpowder did as well. He's here. Radiation sickness? No, he put something in the water. Now, this can go one of two ways. He can either be trying to keep MM safe and out of the fight, or he's going to try to team up with against Homelander. I was expecting him to say quid pro quo, but it wouldn't have been what you lot call. Why do some get multiple powers? You betrayed me and you didn't even get paid for it? He really is the Homelander of Payback. She's the Maeve. Please tell me MM's safe. Good. teaming up with a murderer to take down a murderer, and then they'll take down Soulja Boy. He's going to. Fucking hell, that was a loaded episode. Like, so much shit happened in that hour. Oh, God. So, I wonder how the rest of their team's going to feel about that. By rest of the team, I mean Maeve. How is she going to feel about that? Hey, who knows? Maybe they're in their, I was trying to think of a proper word to say, but no. Between their, during their hookup, or, well, after, she's the one who gave Butcher the idea. Who knows? So, Kimiko is powerless. Which, I don't know what that means, because she was the muscle of the team. Like, sure, they've got the temporary V now, but since Homelander's taken over Vought, then again, he was always on the side of the souped in the military, but, well, probably because it let him go loose, but, yeah, so he'd probably keep up with the temp V and everything. But on the other hand, he said it's a superhero company, not a pharmaceutical company. So maybe he would look away from that kind of stuff. So I can't see Butcher and Huey, like, reliably keeping their supply of temp V. I may have also forgotten that Maeve is currently indisposed somewhere. So they're not going to get that. There's no way to find out how she would feel about their little team up with Soulja Boy. Have we ever gotten Homelander's name before? It just says John. So we don't have a last name. Look, not going to be surprised. It's probably going to be Smith. But so much happened in that episode. We had Ashley and Homelander taking their official positions at the top of Vought and restructuring it to make it a hell of a lot worse. Why would you put the Deep in charge of anything? What is his wife's angle? Like, I seriously want to know, like, what is her angle? Found out, like, Huey found out about Alex. Annie found out about the Temp V and Soulja Boy. There was the Maeve and Butcher hookup. There's everything with Lil Nina, which, yeah, as soon as he stepped out, I knew he wouldn't be coming back because of it. She's not the kind of person that you get away with blowing off. I'm not surprised that MM didn't go for the whole temp V thing. Like, even temporary. Like, it is not in his character to do something like that. And now, Frenchie, he could go for it. I don't see him because he's got his own story this season. Like, sure, there's going to be the rescue, but I don't see him getting in line with taking the V. I wonder if Kimiko was given the proposition of taking that to help her free Frenchie from Lil Nina. Obviously, she'd heal again, get her strength and everything. How would temporary V affect someone who has already had V in them? Like, we've never had a precedent of someone losing their powers before, obviously. Except for, I guess, A-Train, but he did that to himself. It's not so much he doesn't have his power, it's that he can't use his power. But if Kimiko were to say, one, how did she not get completely eviscerated like Crimson Countess did when she took the full blast? I'm assuming because her healing factor was still a part of her for the majority of it, and as soon as the radiation ended, at least I'm assuming it's radiation, whatever the beam that Soldier Boy, I don't know why I mimicked the firing of the laser, but yeah. I'm assuming it's once it's done, her power ended, because otherwise she should have been blasted to shit. Like, it sent her flying through a brick wall, and the only damage she took was from the rebar strut that impaled her. Like, and that was enough to completely destroy a building, atomize a couple people, and char a soup to the bone. Like, but getting back to what I was trying to say before I went on this tangent, what would happen to Kimiko if she took Temp V? Would it just give her old powers for a temporary time? Would it give her new powers for a temporary time? Because as we saw with Stormfront, she had multiple powers. With Soldier Boy, he seems to have multiple powers, because he didn't have that beam when he was in Payback. He also has the whole no aging thing. So that in and of itself is a power. Decelerated aging is a power. Like, so we've got two people who were experimented on after having had the V injected into them that have got multiple powers. And so would it give Kimiko different powers if she took the V? Or would it give her her old powers back permanently? Like, would it reactivate the V? Assuming it wasn't completely burned out of her system, and there's just dregs left in her that's been deactivated, would it reactivate them? Like, I'm assuming we're going to get the answers to this, but who knows? Obviously, anyone who's seen up to the episode in which they do it, but not me. So, anyway, I'm rambling at this point, so I'm going to end this here. I'll catch you in the next one.